Kính chào quý khán thính giả VMTV 55.2. Chúng tôi là tiến sĩ dược khoa Diana Chen. Cảm ơn quý vị rất là nhiều đã trở lại với chương trình với chúng tôi. Đó là sức khỏe thưởng thức. Và cũng như mọi lần, chúng tôi có tiến sĩ Trị Phạm là co-host chung với chúng tôi. Rất tiếc là tiến sĩ Trị Phạm hôm nay có một bệnh nhân nằm trong ICU, trong văn phòng rất là khẩn cấp ở nhà thương MD Anderson. Nên tiến sĩ Trị Phạm không có đến đây để mà thâu chương trình chung với chúng tôi. Kính thưa quý vị, hôm nay chương trình rất là đặc biệt. Chúng tôi nói về một cái đề tài để mà giúp cho phụ nữ làm sao, nhất là phụ nữ Á Đông thành công trong nước Mỹ. Thì chúng tôi rất là hân hạnh là hôm nay chúng tôi mời được hai vị guest đến đây để mà chung vui chung với chia sẻ một cái cơ hội mà một cái hội hợp để mà giúp cho các phụ nữ, nhất là phụ nữ Á Đông của chúng ta thành công trong nước Mỹ. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining Diana. I, of course, as always, our show is always to improve our health of our Vietnamese audience. We looked at all different ways to from health all the way up to psychological health, and now we're looking at spiritual health and also increase our intellectual health. And so this is, I was thinking about the term the other day, and I thought, gosh, you know, this is perfect. So I wanted to share with all of you, and I'm very honor today to introduce to you two a very, very important guests of ours. One is Mrs. Regine G. Calvert.
Thank you, Diana.
Yeah, Mrs. Regine G. Calvert is the co-chair and program director of the Outreach Strategies. And she's the co-chair of the Center for Pacific American Women,
which
we're going to be having a wonderful leadership institute. In addition to, we're very honored to have Mrs. Donna Cole.
Thank you.
Mrs. Donna Cole is the board of director and board of director of the Center for Pacific American Women, and she is also the president and CEO of Cole Chemicals. Ladies, thank you so much for joining.
You're welcome.
We appreciate your presence here today. As always, we have lots and lots of wonderful audience following our show, and I think this particular show will really help so many women out there. But the key here is not just women.
Right.
We're inviting both women, men, students, everyone to come. So if you would, let's start in the beginning of, for those audience that are not familiar with the Center for Pacific, the Center for Asian Pacific American Women. Would you mind sharing with us the history?
Sure. Yes. Well, the actual Center for Asian Pacific American Women was previously the APALI organization, which mm-hmm. is the Asian Pacific Women's Leadership Institute.
Uh-huh.
So their whole goal was to train leaders who were ethical, compassionate, and to put them at leadership tables,
mm-hmm.
right? So that was so important. And about 5 years ago, we changed the name to the Center for Asian Pacific American Women's Leadership.
Mm-hmm.
And in doing so, you know, we have three programs. So the first program would be our one-day workshops, like we're going to do August 17th here
yes.
in Houston. And then they have another summit that's biannual, and that's all over the country. This next year in 2013, it'll be in Los Angeles.
Wow.
And then we also have a fellows program. So it's very compact. 12 women from across the country are selected to go through a 4-week program to really go deep with who they are and to work on being a whole person leadership.
I'm just so excited already.
Yeah.
Yes. So then you mentioned earlier about the leadership seminar, which we understand is called a paradigm shift, work/life blend. Now, this is a very, very interesting title.
Yes.
So if you don't mind, share with our audience, because they're watching right now and they're wondering, gosh, I mean, I want to be part of it, because it just sounds so interesting. So if you don't mind, share with us first, as you mentioned earlier, about the date, time, and the duration, costs, and how can women sign up for this?
Well, let me tell you about the theme first, and hopefully
yes,
get everyone
please.
Excited, and then they can write down
yes.
when it will be. The paradigm shift, of course, means, okay, we're making a change.
Mm-hmm.
And I know that especially we women, have always tried to balance, right? Work-life balance. We've always said balance. Well, what that has said to us is, everything is kind of working in conflict, and you're trying to keep it harmonious, keep it even, keep it balanced. Well, with the Center for Asian Pacific American Women, we believe in whole person leadership. Whole person leadership means you have your head, your heart, and your spirit all involved, that everything works together. And so you are, again, your authentic self. You can be who you truly are. You don't have to be someone different. When you come from work to home, home to school, or to the community, but in all of the different roles in your life, you are the same. So we're saying, let's don't look at our life as a balance, but as a blend, that we move into these different roles and we use everything about us and we can be our true self. So that's how we came up with the work-life balance. And we're gonna have a great speaker talk about that. She exemplifies a great balance. She's a mother, she's a professional, a high-level executive for a major corporation. She works in the community as well, so she's a very good example. Her name is Christine May with Coca-Cola. We're gonna have some wonderful experts to talk about whole person leadership. Peggy Nagai, who is one of our center staff, mm-hmm. and Peggy is an expert in this. She's able to really talk about it in language that people could understand it easily. We have Cheryl, who is going to talk about her style of leadership, mm-hmm. and Cheryl comes from the Hawaiian Islands. She's I'm trying to find Cheryl's last name, Lupeni. Mm-hmm. And Cheryl is just a divine woman. I've met her and she's very calm. But she's gonna share her style from the Hawaiian Pacific Islander side. You know, I think Americans on the mainland get a little frenetic, so we get, you know, real busy and all, but in Hawaii,
yes.
they know how to take things a little easier. Yes. So she's gonna share that kind of style. So we'll have the three of them start the day in what we call the plenary session. And then the afternoon, we'll have breakout sessions where we're gonna focus, and I'm gonna ask Donna to help me here, navigating the corporate culture. And we're gonna have a panel of women who have experienced that. They are successful women in the corporate world. But how do you, again, navigate that corporate culture? It's a different world. Mm-hmm. Language is different. Mm-hmm. There are unspoken rules mm-hmm. that you kind of learn by mistake sometimes. Mm-hmm. So that's going to be interesting.
Yes.
Effective networking.
Effective networking. So networking, we throw that word around. What does it really mean? And some of us, especially the younger set, they have these Facebook and they have all these friends, right? But what is a friend? Is it someone you really can count on? So is your network effective? Are you using mm-hmm. your network well? Mm-hmm. What does it really mean, and how do you make it work for you? We have
the difference between coaching and an advisor or sponsor.
That's right. Mm-hmm. So I think a lot of us have used those concepts of being or getting coaching, mm-hmm. Being a sponsor or being a mentor. Mm-hmm. What does all that mean? When do we know we need a mentor versus a coach? Mm-hmm. So we're going to have an expert talk about that. Kay Awada is going to talk about that. And Kay is just a very smart woman, talks about a lot of issues, but she's going to really break it down for us and see what are you ready for. Or maybe you become a coach or a mentor, mm-hmm. and you can do that to somebody who might need it. Mm-hmm. And then our last session is on
leadership
perspective. So we're going to go more in depth on looking at tools to be a good leader. No matter where you are, you could be in the home, mm-hmm. a leader to your family,
yes.
In the workplace, in your community, if you're active in the PTA or PTO or in your church or something. So wherever you are, how can you be a good leader and how do you develop tools to get you there? And then at lunch, we have a real exciting period. It's not a long lunch, it's about an hour, but we've asked a lot of women locally who have a lot of talents and experiences to share, to be what we call table topic host. Mm. So we'll have tables of, 8 to 10 women, mm-hmm. and it'll be hosted by one of these women. Mm-hmm. And they're gonna talk about anywhere about between generational issues. Many of us are what we call the sandwich generation. Mm-hmm. We are helping our parents and we have still kids. So we're stuck in the middle. Mm-hmm. But there may be some issues intergenerationally, interculturally. This is a global world now. And in the workplace and even personally, we have a lot of interracial marriages, mm-hmm. intercultural mm-hmm. marriages. Yes. And how do we sometimes have to work through some of those issues? Mm-hmm. Again, the corporate world, but some real individual experiences they can talk about. So this table topic is going to be a smaller arena where people can exchange and talk about their experiences. Mm. It's a full day, Diana.
Yes, yes.
We start about 8:30 until 4:30, mm-hmm. and then we'll have a chance to network from about 4:30 to 6, with just a chance to enjoy each other's company. And it will be at the Houston Community College downtown, 3100 Main at Elgin. The cost is, you can go online, and I'll give you that in a minute, but the cost is $125 for full registration, $50 for students and nonprofit staff. The website is www.apawomen.org, O-R-G, so yes. apawomen.org. Mm-hmm. And if they, you know, click that in, they should come to the website, and then that they should look for the Houston One Day Leadership Seminar.
Great. Wow, so then the event starting at from 8:30 to almost ends at 5:30. That's a whole
exactly.
day event.
Yeah, it is.
And I think that's really a bargain to invest either $125 or $50 in yeah. for leadership. That's really, really a great bargain.
A lot of talented people to help. Mm-hmm. And also we're going to have breakfast.
Mm-hmm. Breaks, lunch,
and
a reception.
Yep. And the reception, wow. Yeah.
So it's a really good deal, as
yes.
you said. It's
yes.
a great bargain and a good investment in somebody's personal leadership development.
Yes, yes, and I see here that there's going to be some bingo games used to help to network
right.
People with prizes and surprises, certain
right.
Prize drawings maybe.
We're going to have some drawings, and
wow.
what's really nice about the networking piece is that you get to network at lunch at those tables.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll even have somebody there, Diana, who's a coach.
Uh-huh.
So no question is off limits.
Yes.
So if you have an issue and you want to bring it forth in this group, because it's a small confined group and everything stays at the table, right?
Yes.
They can ask away and feel good that somebody's going to give them an answer, some advice mm-hmm. and recommendations.
I see. Now, we talked about women, but what is this seminar open both for men, women, students, everyone? I understand.
Yeah. Well, you know, leadership development happens in whether you're a woman, a man, whether you're Asian, African American, Hispanic, Caucasian.
Yes.
And so we say at the open to the public sessions that we have,
mm-hmm.
if you're Asian, please come. And if you're not Asian, if you play, live, or work with an Asian, you should come.
It's, you know, such a diverse world, and Houston is one of the most diverse cities in the country. So there's probably every, you know, opportunity to know Asians. So like Donna said, if you work, play, you know, live with Asians, it gives you insights as to kind of the Asian culture.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little unique. Mm-hmm. There are some issues and there are some traditions and all that sometimes create situations that we respond the way we do. So it does give non-Asians insights about the Asian culture.
Yes.
So it's a very good learning opportunity.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Now, I understand you shared with us the website earlier, but what about those, the audience that may not have a computer and cannot register? So the computer, is there someone that they could call and said, please, I reserve 2 seats for me or 10
yeah,
seats or a whole
absolutely.
Table for my organization, for those businesses out there that are interested in purchasing tickets for their employees? Can they do that as well
they
to register?
They can call Rosie Abram.
Oh, right.
And Rosie is the president of the Center for Asian Pacific American Women. And mm-hmm. I see you've got the number there.
Yes.
So I'm going to let you say the number.
The number is 415-310-6978. and it's a California number. Uh-huh. But if that's a problem, let me give you a local number, because we don't want it to be a hardship for anybody.
Yes.
So a local number is 832. I don't even remember my own number. 832-723-4508. And that is Rogene, R-O-G-E-N-E. Just call me and I will make sure that they get registered.
Mm-hmm. Yes. So now we have talked already the how to contact, how to sign up for the program, the Leadership Institute, the seminar, and then we've talked about the various insight in the afternoon sessions. As far as, if you don't mind sharing with us a little bit more, you talked about earlier in how to network. Networking, for many of our audience, especially as our Vietnamese older generation, perhaps, to go and to walk up to someone, just hand them a business card. And they're very shy. At first, you have to shake hands, perhaps maybe smile, eye contact, just warm, get the warmness with the person, of course, and the politeness of rather just handing the card.
That's right.
So then could you share a little bit tidbit so that perhaps maybe our audience, as they're watching, they have a little bit idea of what they're going to be learning, because I think for some this would be a learning experience.
Sure. Well, as you walk into any room and you see people and you want to make contact, mm-hmm. you find something about that person that you like.
Yes.
Is it the dress? Is it the purse? Is it the shoes?
Yes.
Is it the man's tie?
Uh-huh.
You like the way they wear their hair? Wish you could. So there's a lot of ways to break the ice.
Yes.
And I think you're right. For Asians in particular, it's very difficult mm-hmm. for them to meet other people and to build that relationship and start networking.
Yes.
So, and then the other is, to be able to walk up to somebody and give them your 30-second elevator pitch, right? Hi, I'm so-and-so,
yes.
right? I don't know anybody in this room. Are you familiar with everybody? So mm-hmm. there's all kinds of ways to start that conversation.
Yes.
And somebody may say, no, this is my first time.
Yes.
Mine too. Well,
yes.
Let's go find somebody.
Yes.
Who knows something about the organization.
Yes. Yes.
So tips on how to break the ice, as mm-hmm. they say, and to start building a network of people that you could count on, that you could call, and you can, use for whatever needs that you might have.
Great. Well, I am going to share this information in Vietnamese, and as we come to the second part of our show, let's talk a little bit, let's go a little bit more in depth of what the afternoon sessions will be. Kính thưa quý vị, chúng tôi rất là hân hạnh là chúng tôi mời được hai vị guest của chúng tôi đến đây, đó là bà Mrs. Rogene G. Calvert và also bà Mrs. Donna Cole. And hai vị đây là đại diện cho the Center for Asian Pacific American Women. Thì chúng tôi chia sẻ là cái hội đồng này là thành lập lúc mà năm 1995, là gọi là Châu Á Thái Bình Dương ở tại Hoa Kỳ đây, và chuyên môn về giúp cho quý phụ nữ lãnh đạo viên và cũng như là thành công cho tất cả về giúp cho quý phụ nữ cung cấp đào tạo những người phụ nữ lãnh đạo cho phụ nữ Á Châu có nhiều thêm đạo đức, chăm sóc và từ bi để mà đặt tại quyết định bản của người phụ nữ đó. Và đây là một cái cơ hội mà rất là đặc biệt. Chúng tôi biết sau khi mà xong thông tin thương mại đó thì là chúng tôi sẽ chia sẻ thêm đến quý vị, là cho tất cả các phụ nữ, các quý ông, các quý em mà đang đi học trường đại học, mà muốn là cũng như làm sao mà mình học hỏi để mà mình thành công thêm trong cái nghề lãnh đạo của mình. Thí dụ như là mình là một người salesman, hay là một người là luật sư, bác sĩ. Làm sao cái lớp này mình có thể đi học, cái lớp này là chỉ có một ngày thôi, nhưng mà mình học hỏi rất là nhiều. Thì sau khi mà thông tin thương mại thì chúng tôi sẽ chia sẻ thêm đến quý vị. Cảm ơn quý vị rất nhiều, và hẹn quý vị lại trong phần 2 của chương trình của chúng tôi, đó là Sức Khỏe Thưởng Thức. Thank you. Thêm một lần nữa, chúng tôi là tiến sĩ dược khoa Diana Chen. Cảm ơn quý vị rất là nhiều đã trở lại với chương trình của chúng tôi. Đó là sức khỏe thưởng thức. Và đây là phần 2 của chương trình. Chúng tôi mời hai vị guest, đó là Mrs. Regine G. Calvert and also Mrs. Donna Cole. Hai vị guest của chúng tôi thì hôm nay chia sẻ về the Center for Asian Pacific American Women. Ladies, thank you so much again, Mrs. Calvert.
Thank you.
I think you're very well known as Mrs. Regine.
Oh, thank
Regine
you, Diana.
G. Calvert, and then also Mrs. Donna Cole. Earlier, we had talked about the part one. We had squeezed in a little bit about networking. You talked right. about the exchanging of business cards and the breaking of ice, what to say, say, you know, to look at. When you walk into a room, it's very nerve-wracking. When you walk into a room and not knowing anyone, and you talked about different ways to break the ice. Now, how about, let's go a little bit further. Okay. After we network, after we had received that card, what do we do with that card? Yep. Should we bring it home, put it in a drawer somewhere, mm-hmm. or should we put it really neat in a place and then maybe... Sure. Look it up later. Well, what should one do with that yeah. business card?
Well, I can tell you what I do is I usually, you know, you always ask somebody, right, if it's appropriate to write on their card, because some people don't like you to write on their card. Mm-hmm. So you turn it over and, yes. and maybe take a note, you
yes.
know, like they're a doctor or, you know, they're a nurse mm-hmm. or they work, they're a tax accountant.
Uh-huh.
You know, just write on the back and then always write down where I was and
yes.
the date
uh-huh.
so that if I ever want to refer back to that person.
Yes.
And, you know, sometimes I always ask people, so what is it that you want to do mm-hmm. or need help with?
Mm-hmm.
Because if I know that, then I can connect you
yes.
with Regine or somebody else that I know in the community mm-hmm. to help you get what you need,
mm-hmm.
right? So that's part of the networking. And I think, you know, for Asians, it's, you know, doing something for somebody and not expecting something back.
Mm-hmm.
Where in the American culture, it's, I do something for you so you know you owe me.
Uh-oh.
Right?
Yeah,
so
that's
I think
true.
That's the two difference between the Asian culture mm-hmm. and the American culture here.
Yes.
So in terms of this networking, we do have a networking game.
Uh-huh.
And it's a bingo game
yes.
that we do it by people instead of numbers and letters.
Uh-huh.
So instead of N59, we would go around the room with our bingo card and ask you, have you sailed the high seas? No, okay. And what is your name? And you talk to, you know, you
mm-hmm.
and you find out, no, it wasn't me, or what did you do?
Mm-hmm.
And then maybe I'll fill your name in the slot.
Uh-huh.
Oh, you lived in Germany for a while,
uh-huh.
so I'll put Diana's name down,
uh-huh.
right? Or Regine, you
yes.
know, I'll say, oh, and do you have two children? Did you go to University of Texas? So there's all kinds of little bits and pieces of information about somebody.
Mm-hmm.
So you fill in the card, and you know, it's diagonal or up and down, horizontal,
mm-hmm.
whether you win. Now, you keep playing for the rest of the day, because the whole idea is to get all of your card filled in.
Mm-hmm.
And if you get all of your card filled in,
mm-hmm.
then you get a trip to the summit. In
uh-huh.
September of next year in Los Angeles
uh-huh.
and attend the summit. So we'll give a free registration away.
Oh.
And then we have other small prizes
mm-hmm.
for those who win the columns and the diagonals.
Oh, wow. So this is not only will you be intellectually receiving information to become a better person, but here it is ways to network and win prizes at the same time.
Right, right. Exactly.
Wow, this is very, very, very neat. I love it. I love it already, so you can definitely count me in.
Oh, that's great,
Diana. Yes, yes, and all of our fans out there, we have lots of fans that watches our show, especially our young audience. We have lots of high school audience as well that watches the show to learn more about health improvements. And this will be definitely, especially in the summertime, I don't think school starts until the 27th of
yep,
this month.
That's right.
So this would be great for those high school students. In fact, I know for sure I'll be taking my daughter to be with us. And in fact, I mentioned to my mother as well. And so hopefully she's able
great.
To come. So this is going to
three
be...
Three generations.
Yes, yes. It's very, very, yes. And we encourage for moms and grandmas.
That's exactly right. And when
and
we designed the program,
mm-hmm.
we really had an eye for all three generations, if you will, or age levels, because they're also at different points in their career.
Yes.
So we will very much enjoy having your daughter and younger people. And that's why we have a discount for students.
Yes.
So that we can encourage them to come, mm-hmm. number one. And then in terms of where you are in your career, our sessions are geared toward either tenured professionals who have been in the field for a while, mm-hmm. and their issues will be different than, say, maybe someone who just started mm-hmm. in their career, mm-hmm. or maybe in within 5 years, sort of middle right. of their career or yes. early career. Mm-hmm. And so that's going to be good too. Our mm-hmm. hope was that we would attract all these different age groups and professional levels so
yes.
that there will be intermingling.
Yes.
One of our topics, as I mentioned, especially at the table topic, will be intergenerational, so we may have to have you, your daughter, and your mother sit at that table to discuss
oh, yes.
how issues are between the different generations.
Yes, yes, we would be very honored to, right. Yes, and I think I'm also going to be participating
yes,
as a panelist
yes.
For the for the navigating of the corporate culture.
Right.
So I think that would it's going to be
right.
very
how
wonderful.
Do you go up in an organization
mm-hmm.
rather
yes.
than out?
Right,
or
right.
get left abandoned in an area and never really achieve any more than that one slot.
Yes.
So that's what that will help you with is career. So we look forward to hearing from you and your
yes.
comments
thank
and
you.
Advice.
Thank you.
And then the other part about coaching and mentoring and mm-hmm. advisors and
yes.
sponsors,
yes.
you know, that can happen whether you're in school
mm-hmm.
or you're working mm-hmm. or in a community center or church. You
yes.
know, it's who do you get advice from?
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
And is it good advice?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Have I outgrown this person and I need somebody else?
Mm-hmm.
So they also teach you a nice way of letting go
mm-hmm.
and finding that other person to fill in the void.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
Knowing in a corporate organization, you always want a sponsor, right?
Yes.
And some people, most Asians, don't have sponsors because
mm-hmm.
they don't know how to ask
that's
and
true.
Seek one.
That's
so
true.
That's why people should come.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. Definitely to ask for mentors. I remember back then I was encouraged back when I was in school for working on my master's. I was encouraged by my professor to say, mm-hmm. make sure that you have a personal mentor,
mm-hmm.
someone that you can come to cry to,
yep.
to
yeah.
scream, to receive hugs from a personal standpoint.
Right, yeah.
But then also have a professional mentor that can give you guidance yeah. to move forward, whether you are owning a nail shop. And
yeah,
maybe,
right.
or perhaps maybe you're currently working in a nail shop and wish to someday own a nail
that's
shop.
Right.
How do you do that? Or
right.
perhaps you're currently an attorney and one day want to own your own practice. Or perhaps you are working in a chemical engineer company and someday want to be the president
yeah,
and CEO
right. exactly.
or be the director of yeah. of an organization. So I think it's just the doors are just endless. But I think what's really interesting to mention regarding to seek for mentors is to be a mentee,
mm-hmm.
to serve, to give back.
Exactly.
As a mentor, when we have, for myself, for example, I have quite a few of mentees, whether they're in high school or in college or currently in pharmacy school. Part of my work is an adjunct faculty for the University of Houston
oh,
and TSU, and we teach students. We
yes.
The interns, we call them interns.
Yes.
They don't like to be called students. Mm-hmm. They're on PharmD, so they like to be called interns. And I remember when they see successful women such as yourself, they would like to learn. And say, gosh, you know, how do I become a president and CEO of a company?
Right.
How do you manage that? I mean, where did you get your skills? And I think to be part of this program, to be part of this Leadership Institute, the seminar is the first step,
mm-hmm.
correct?
Right.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yes.
And we do encourage people to mentor others.
Yes.
Because it's so important to pay it forward.
Yes.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And then the other piece, too, is this intergenerational in the workforce.
Mm-hmm.
So now you go into the workplace
yes.
and you have people who are what they call veterans,
mm-hmm.
right? So they were born before the 1930s,
mm-hmm.
right, 1935.
Right.
And then you have the baby boomers
yes.
who were born, you know, in the 40s and 50s.
Yes.
And then you have the Generation Xers
right.
and
yes.
Ys and Gen
yes.
X. And
yes.
there's a new millennials.
Yes, millennials.
So
yes.
now that you have all of those in the workplace,
mm-hmm.
how do you build an effective communication for all of them.
Yes.
Right? Because there are some things that they have shared values and other things that they don't value the same things, right? In terms of, let's say, communication. So maybe I would prefer picking up the phone and talking to you.
Yes.
But, you know, a millennial would rather just touch you.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So we also touch on those points in this intergenerational piece at the lunch topic. So we encourage people to come and sit with that coach. Her name's Bonnie. And she'll just do a great job in helping you build a team, an effective team, and be able to communicate properly.
Yes.
Just picking up on that, I think it really becomes critical in the workplace when you have someone younger supervising someone older.
Very true.
That's when it's really hard, I think. You know, there's just the communication is one, how you communicate, but also just the fact that, hey, I'm older than you. Why are you telling me what to do? So attitude, and it makes it very hard.
Yes.
And as we know, people are staying in the workplace longer now because many can't afford to retire.
That's true.
Or, you know, they choose to work longer because we're living longer.
Yes.
And we see that happening a lot. So I think it's great. And to have someone like Bonnie and some of the others we're going to have who are professionals at this, and they're actually volunteering their time for us that day to give advice. It's going to be priceless.
Yes, it is priceless. And also even, let's say, topics that we should not talk at work or maybe hold to a minimum, right? What do you recommend not to, to hold, to keep more to yourself, right, rather than, you know, the gossip, of course. We don't want gossip.
Well, and another is that, you know, you may get a review that says you need communication skills improvement. Well, what does that really mean?
Right.
Well, and it may translate that you have an accent.
Yeah.
And people can't understand you, and so you're being talked over at meetings. And so before long, you realize you're slumping down in your seat and you're not really answering the questions because nobody gives you the time of day, right?
Yes.
So we have another woman who's going to help with that in accent reduction and giving presentations. So I just encourage anybody where if you're, appraisal, your employee appraisal says you need to improve your communication skills, you got to sit at Bonnie's table, right?
Yes.
Miriam.
Yes.
Oh, Miriam's table. That's right. Miriam, sorry.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. You're absolutely correct, because now we live in a litigious society, and when we, as you talked about being an appraiser, when we do a review evaluation of an employee, and if we're not cautious, that employee can turn around and sue the company or sue the individual, their boss. Why did I get fired? What is the reason?
Right.
So it's just, oh my goodness, it's endless, isn't it?
It is endless.
Well, and because we have a Vietnamese audience, I think Donna brings up a good point. Because I've worked in the public sector a lot, and I hear from employees that, you know, I've been working here for 25, 30 years, and you know, we're good workers. That's one thing about Asians, that they're hard workers, but I don't see myself getting promoted. And a lot of times it is because of the communication limitations, the accent, or just not speaking up, not feeling comfortable, or not knowing how to, because we are taught to, you know, kind of be reserved and not to be heard. We're respectful to listen to others. Well, that doesn't always work in the Western world, in the American system, in the workplace. So we get graded down for that. So these are all important issues that maybe amongst people that would understand, again, uniquenesses in the Asian culture. And there may be non-Asians that know about this because they've worked with those that have these issues. It would help them understand how to express it. So we hope that we'll see a good variety and, you know, different people come.
Yes, yes. And now, would you like to share any sponsors out there that you would wish to thank publicly?
Absolutely. Well, you know, Van TV 55.2, we have to thank for being here today as
well. Thank you very much.
We have ExxonMobil as a sponsor. We have Shell as a sponsor. CenterPoint Energy, the Edison Electric Institute. We also have Amogee Bank. Houston Community College, of course, because it's being hosted at their facility.
Yes.
So they've been so kind in having us come there.
Yeah,
I want to give a shout out to Cole Chemical.
Yes,
because,
definitely.
Because Donna has always been there for the community, and this particular group, she has been such a strong advocate to give us the opportunity to have these speakers come and to have this open to the community, because you know, you don't always get this kind of talent out there, and as you say, it's a bargain.
It is truly a bargain. Is there anything that we have missed that you would like to share with our audience?
Well, I would love for everybody to come, men, women of all age groups, please come. And whatever is burning on your chest, we want you to release it at this conference, okay? And get some good advice.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And anything else that you would like
to
share?
I just echo what Donna said.
Yes.
And thank you, Dinah, for allowing us to share it with the Vietnamese community. And we hope we see many of them come.
Oh, did you say that it was Friday, next Friday, August 17th?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
We did mention, Mrs. Calvert had mentioned
good.
The date, but definitely we would
write
the flyer up on the screen there, and you can see there is the August 17th Friday, beginning at 8:30. We encourage you, of course, to come a little early so you can find
register parking.
And parking is not too far.
It's just a block away, and it's free, so
yes.
they don't have to worry, but yeah, it's just a block away.
Yes, and most people, they may be afraid to come to downtown, so there will be a big sign to say park here if you're going to the institute. Great. So kính thưa quý vị, chúng tôi hồi nãy chia sẻ với quý vị là cái ngày chương trình đại hội là lúc đầu đó là sẽ bắt đầu bắt là 8:30 sáng đến 5:30 chiều và sẽ tổ chức ở tại trung tâm là gọi là Houston Kimmy College, trong cái đường là 3100 ở trên đường Elgin ở downtown, và cái địa chỉ, nếu mà quý vị các bạn trẻ mà thích ghi danh ở trên cái website gọi là www.apawomen.org, and đây là một cái cơ hội rất là đặc biệt. Quý vị sẽ các bạn trẻ, chúng tôi biết là các bạn trẻ, quý vị mà mới ra trường, các em mới vừa ra trường đại học, hay là có thể là các anh chị mà cũng hiện nay thí dụ như là muốn một ngày nào đó làm chủ một cái hãng xưởng, hay là có thể là một ngày nào đó làm president của một cái hội organization, hay là cũng có thể rằng là làm CEO của một cái company, thì đây là một cái cơ hội rất là đặc biệt. Gosh, it looks like that we have ended our session here today, and so we've so much enjoyed Institute to learn about the Leadership Institute, and we look forward, I'm sure all of our audience look forward to coming on the show and to being at the Institute, but watching the show here, they've already learned so much from all the tidbits that you have been sharing. So once again, Mrs. Calvert and Mrs. Cole, we appreciate your presence here today on Ven TV, Vietnamese Network Television. Kính thưa quý vị, chúng tôi cảm ơn quý vị rất là nhiều đã trở lại với chương trình với chúng tôi. Đó là sức khỏe thưởng thức. Và cũng như mọi lần, chúng tôi nhớ là quý vị đừng có quên cái chương trình của chúng tôi đón xem. Đó là mỗi thứ hai lúc mà 2:00 trưa và ngày thứ bảy là cũng là 2:30 trưa. Vâng, cảm ơn quý vị rất là nhiều. Thêm một lần nữa, chúng tôi là tiến sĩ Diệp Khoa Diana Trần. Cảm ơn quý vị rất nhiều đã theo dõi chương trình Sức khỏe thưởng thức ở tại truyền hình VenTV 55.2.